ocean shore is a perfect destination to have fun with family and friends. The ocean is never still. It is constantly in motion. These motions are the results of waves, tides, and ocean currents. In this video, I'm going to talk about tides. Hi, I'm Vanilla, and you're watching The Learning Curve. We all know that waves are commonly caused by the winds, while tides, on the other hand, are caused by the combined efforts of the gravitational forces exerted by the moon and the sun and the rotation of the earth. Let me give a simple explanation. Just consider this level to be the sea level. But the sea level is not constant. Sometimes this rises and sometimes it falls. This phenomenon that makes the water either go up or down is known as the tide. When the sea level rises to its highest level, it is called the high tide. And when it reaches its lowest level, it is called the low tide. Due to the gravitational force from the moon, the Earth's ocean is squeezed towards the Earth-Moon line. This leads to two bulges of water on opposite side of the Earth. In addition to this, the Earth also experiences a gravitational force from the Sun. But the effect of Sun's gravity is less compared to the Moon because the Sun is far away from the Earth. When we are in one of these bulges, we experience high tide, and in the other region, we experience the low tide. We know that the Earth orbits the Sun once every 365 days and rotates about its axis once every 24 hours. Let's consider this region on the Earth. As the Earth rotates, this region of the Earth passes through both of these bulges every 24 hours. This means in 24 hours, we'll experience two high tides and two low tides. But there is one more thing we need to consider before concluding this. The moon is not stationary. It revolves around the Earth in 27 days, 7 hours and 43 minutes. Our Earth must travel a little further in its path to catch up to the moon. It needs 50 minutes to do this. Therefore, we experience two high tides and two low tides every 24 hours and 50 minutes. Most shorelines experience this cycle. However, some areas have just one of each. In this tidal cycle, we have a high tide followed by the low tide, which is followed by the high tide and again a low tide. This cycle repeats continuously. Since two high tides and two low tides occur in 24 hours and 50 minutes, it takes 6 hours and 12.5 minutes for the water at the shore to go from high to low, and then another 6 hours and 12.5 minutes from low to high. As the moon orbits the Earth, the tidal bulge is moving with the moon. It means the tides that the moon rises on the Earth are the same no matter what phase of the moon you see in the sky. Around the new moon and full moon, when the sun, moon and the Earth form a line, the solar tidal force will add up with the moon's tidal force. As a result, the tides range is at its maximum during the full moon and the new moon. This is called the spring tide. When the moon is in its first quarter or third quarter, the sun and the moon are separated by 90 degrees when viewed from the Earth. Then, the solar tidal force partially cancels the moon's tidal force. At these times, the tides range is at its minimum. This is called the Neap tide. Ocean tides are one of the most predictable natural phenomena. Do you think we can generate electricity using these tides? Of course we can. My next video is about this interesting topic. Bye, see you all there.